विश्व भर में लोगों से कहना चाहता हूं, कम मेक इन इंडिया।
दिस गैदरिंग अ मैन विद अ विजन एंड अ मैन ऑन अ मिशन टुवर्ड्स क्रिएटिंग अ ब्यूटिफुल सस्टेनेबल प्लैनेट।
My friend Prime Minister Ralph Gonsalves, Srimati Amina Ji, Ibrahim Chiao, my minister colleague Prakash Javadekar, Babul Supriyo, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to India for the 14th session of the Conference of Parties to the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. I thank the Executive Secretary, Mr. Ibrahim Chiao, for having brought this convention to India. The record registration of this program reflects the global commitment to the task of reversing land degradation. India also looks forward to making an effective contribution as we take over the co-presidency for a two-year term. Friends, for ages, we in India have always given importance to land. In Indian culture, the earth is held as sacred and treated as a mother. While getting up in morning, when we touch the earth with our feet, we seek forgiveness of Mother Earth by praying Samudra Vasane Devi Parvatastana Mandale Vishnu Patni Namastubhyam Padas Parsam Kshamaswame. Friends, climate and environment impact both biodiversity and land. It is widely accepted that the world is facing the negative impact of climate change. This is seen in a loss of land and plants and animal species, facing threats of becoming extinct. Climate change is also leading to land degradation of various kinds, be it due to rise in sea levels and wave action, erratic rainfall and storms, and sandstorms caused by hot temperatures. Ladies and gentlemen, India has hosted global gathering through the COP for all the three conventions. This reflects our commitment to addressing all the three main concerns of the Rio Convention. Going forward, India would be happy to propose initiatives for greater South-South cooperation in addressing issue of climate change, biodiversity, and land degradation. Friends, you will be shocked to know that desertification affects over 2/3 of the countries of the world. This makes a compelling case for action on land front. Combine this with the water crisis facing the world. Because when we address degraded lands, we also address water scarcity. Augmenting water supply, enhancing water recharge, slowing down water runoff, and retaining moisture in the soil are all parts of a holistic land and water strategy. I call upon the leadership of UNCCD to create a global water action agenda which is central to the land degradation neutrality strategy. Friends, restoring the health of land is critical for sustainable development. Today, I reminded of India's NDCs that were submitted at the Paris COP, at the UNFCCC. It highlighted India's deep cultural roots of maintaining a healthy balance between land, water, air, trees, and all living beings. Friends, it would make you happy that India has been able to increase its tree cover. Between 2015 to 2017, India's tree and forest cover had been increased by 0.8 million hectares. In India, any diversion of forest land for development purposes has to be compensated by making an equivalent land mass available for afforestation. It is also required a monetary payment of the value of timber which such forest land would have yield. I'm happy to share that only last week, funds amounting to nearly $6 billion, means 40 to 50,000 crore rupees, have been released to the provincial governments in lieu of such diversion for development of forest lands. My government had launched a program to double the income of farmers by increasing crop yield through various measures. This includes land restoration and micro irrigation. We are working with the motto of per drop, more crop. At the same time, we are also focusing on zero budget natural farming. We have also introduced a scheme to determine the soil quality of each of the farms and are issuing soil health cards to farmers. This enables them to grow right type of crops, fertilizers, and use the right quantity of water. So far, about 217 million soil health cards have been distributed. We are increasing the use of biofertilizers and reducing the use of pesticides and chemical fertilizers. Water management is another important issue addressed LDN. We have created Jal Shakti Ministry to address all water-related important issues in totality. Recognizing the value of water in all forms, we enforce zero liquid discharge in many industrial processes. The regulatory regime provides for treatment of wastewater to a degree that it can be put back into the river system without harming life in water. Friends, I would like to draw your attention to another form of land degradation, which if not prevented, would be impossible to reverse. This is the menace of plastic waste. Apart from having adverse health implications, this is going to render lands unproductive and unfit for agriculture. My government has announced that India will put an end to single-use plastic in the coming years. We are committed to development of environment-friendly substitutes and also an efficient plastic collection and disposal method. I believe the time has come for even the world to say goodbye to single-use plastic. Friends, human empowerment is closely linked to the state of the environment. Be it harnessing water resources or reducing usage of single-use plastic, the way ahead is behavioral change. It is only when all sections of society decide to achieve something, we can see the desired results. We may introduce any number of frameworks, but real change will be powered by teamwork on the ground. India saw this in the case of the Swachh Bharat mission. People from all walks of life took part and ensured sanitation coverage was up from 38% in 2014 to 99% today. I am seeing the same spirit when it comes to ensuring the end of single-use plastic. Youngsters in particular are most supportive and are taking the lead to bring positive change. The media is also playing a very valuable role. Friends, I would like to make further commitment to the global land agenda. I also offer India's support to those countries who may like to understand and adopt some of the LDN strategies that have succeeded in India. From this forum, I would like to announce that India would raise its ambition of the total area that would be restored from its land degradation status from 21 million hectares to 26 million hectares between now and 2030. This will support India's large commitment to achieve an additional carbon sink between 2.5 billion metric tons to 3 billion metric tons through tree cover. We in India take pride in using remote sensing and space technology for multiple applications, including land restoration. India would be happy to help other friendly countries develop land restoration strategies through cost-effective satellite and space technology. In order to further develop a scientific approach and facilitate induction of technology to land degradation issues, we have decided to set up a center for excellence in India at the Indian Council of Forestry Research and Education. This agency will actively engage to promote South-South cooperation with those who may wish to access knowledge, technology, and training of manpower to address land degradation related issues. Friends, I understand that an ambitious New Delhi declaration is being considered. We are all aware that the Sustainable Development Goals have to be achieved by 2030, of which attainment of L&D is also a part. I wish you well as you deliberate further towards proposing a global strategy for land degradation neutrality. I would end by saying a very popular prayer from one of our oldest scriptures, Om Dayoho Shantihi, Antariksham Shantihi. The word Shanti does not only refer to peace or the antidote to violence. Here, it refers to prospering. Everything has a law of being, a purpose, and everybody has to fulfill that purpose. The fulfillment of that purpose is prosperity. Om Dayoho Shantihi, Antriksha Shantihi. So, it says, may the skies, heaven and space prosper. Prithvihi Shantihi, Apaha Shantihi, Aushadaya Shantihi, Manaspataya Shantihi, Vishve Devaha Shantihi, Brahma Shantihi. May Mother Earth prosper. This includes the flora and fauna with whom we share our planet. May they prosper. May every drop of water prosper. May the divine gods prosper. Sarva Shantihi, Shanti Reva Shantihi, Same Shanti Redai. May everybody prosper. May I also be blessed with prosperity. Om Shantihi, Shantihi, Shantihi. Om prosperity, prosperity is prosperity. The thought and philosophy of our ancestors was all embracing and filled with a great thought. They realized the true relationship between me and we. They knew that prosperity of me can only be through prosperity of we. When our ancestors said we, they did not just mean their family or community or even just humans. It includes the sky, water, plants, trees, everything. It is also very important to know the order in which they are praying for peace and prosperity. They pray for the sky, the earth, the water, the plants. These are things that sustain us. This is what we call the environment. If this prosper, then I prosper. This was their mantra. Even today, this is an extremely relevant thought. With this spirit, I once again congratulate you for taking part in this summit. Thank you. Thank you very much.